radical love? Radical love is an unconditional love. It is a love that is filled with humanity, compassion, and understanding. It is vast. It is wide-ranged. And that is the kind of love that God has for us when He sent His only Son to die brutally and terribly just to pay for our sins. Radical love is what that cross is all about.
Take my heart, of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one you could ever say. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me to your love to those around me. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say yes, Lord. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your love and lead me in your love to those around me. Oh, I will.
Thank you.
basta't ikaw ang kasama, panatana. Kahit kailan, di ka na kulang, biyaya mo sa akin laging lang. Ang pag-ibig mo sasambahin, paligid man ay magdilim, Jesus. Kahit may suliraning man, lagi kang naawitan, ikaw lamang. Kahit kailan
good morning, everyone. I trust that God's blessings you have experienced this week as you and I have continued to put our trust in Him. Thank you so much, praise and worship team, Dindin and Jimalo and the instrumentalist for providing us those songs of God is here, and I will build my life upon your love, and it is a firm foundation. This week had been a challenge for some families of the death of their loved ones. Thank you also, Pastor Marian, for that prayer. although that we are living in this troubled world and many challenges in life, death has come, but yet we know that God is on our side. Amen. And as I've said, the Samson and Bergara family lost Hazel. She used to come worship with us before the pandemic, but she has gone through dialysis for a number of months, and that she has just given up. And that also Sylvia Mirazol, the wife of Pastor Jim Madar, also had that early departure, and we just empathize with the family and also with the Palero family of the death of Mrs. Berihida Palero, whom I know as a little boy as one of the early pastors in the Methodist Church. As I was visiting them, my heart goes with them. This is not an easy days for them. For Hazel, it was sickness. And for Sylvia, it might be also just sickness or some other challenges. But for Brihida Palero, because she is of old age, 84, and so we just say that maybe it's time for her to go. But even though it's time for her to go, it is still difficult for the family. You know, experiencing or overcoming struggles, difficulties, obstacles, and challenges in life is not really easy as we can see it. At these times of so many challenges that we face, our world is lurking from one crisis to another. We experience global pandemic, dramatic changes in many areas as to how we conduct our daily lives and how we see our economic uncertainty and how we can see the political and social turmoil in our land, as well as different array of natural disasters. Sometimes we wonder, nindot man sa una nga bulan ngayon nini in the past year, kay pirmi lang init, way linog, way bagyo. But these days, different. Then there is what I call the personal trauma that people are dealing with, such as the loss of a loved one. As I have just mentioned this last week, for those of us who have visited, those who have experienced death in the family, it is a personal trauma for them. The loss of a loved one, declining health. We see each one so strong, so healthy, in the following day or the following weeks, so weak as well. Personal trauma such as unemployment. Many desire to be employed in order to meet their needs. Personal trauma such as family problems. Last night I was called by someone, and early this morning I was called again because of family problems and trouble. You know, tragic accidents, sometimes we wonder why that C-130 landed or went into that kind of accident that killed so many soldiers. They have people dream of bright future. Their families have long desired for them to be in the military. But all of a sudden, that dream is cut off. You know, for many of us, this is a time of unprecedented struggle and upheaval. Whether the source of the disruption in our lives is global emergency or personal trauma or personal tragedy, both living through difficult times can take a heavy challenge on our mood. I mean, our mental capacity, our state of mind and our feelings. This mood, so happy, the next hour, it can be a difficult way to explain. Living through this kind of life, of all these tragedies, not only affects our mood, but also it affects our health. Not just the physical, but also the mental. Pastora Marian said in her prayer that may those people who have mental challenged will be healed as well. In these days of so much difficulty, physical aspect is being affected, mental, social well-being, not just the absence of illness, not just the absence of infirmity, but even it can affect our mood, it can affect our health, but even our outlook in life. Kanang atong pagtan-aw ba sa kinabuhi? Your point of view, the general point attitude to life. You know, in all of these challenges, it can leave us feeling helpless and overwhelmed by stress and anxiety. You may be painfully grieving all that we have lost, the difficulties that we face, the conflicting emotions deep within, and the uncertainties that is in the future sometimes can paralyze us in moving towards that direction. And then we may say that life is totally out of control these days. And we may feel that we are powerless. How we can live in the next day or weeks in our lives? Whether you are facing global or personal trauma or crisis, or both of these, I think there is one way that we can cope up with all these challenges. And the song that we have just sung, we sang today, that God is here, that God is here, that God is here, and I will put my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. And you know, that is not just a song, but that is a message in itself. In all of these challenges that we are seeing, you know, we need to build that kind of, what is it, resiliency. That we are able to move a little bit, swinging and move back and forth in trusting the Lord that He has a good plan for our lives. In Psalm chapter 90, it is a prayer of Moses. I will not read the whole chapter, but I will just read verses 13 to 17, to the last verse. This chapter, someone said, that's been written by Moses himself. And Moses is a person who's been called by God, spent 40 years in Egypt, had been trained in Egypt, given wisdom, and he was sent into the desert for 40 years in isolation. And verse 13 says, "Relent, O Lord, how long will it be? Have your compassion on your servants. Satisfy us in the morning with your unfailing love, that we may sing for joy and be glad all our days. Make us glad for many days as you have afflicted us, as many years we have seen troubled. May your deeds be shown to your servants, your splendor to your children. Verse 17, may the favor of the Lord our God rest upon us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. How long? Each one of us probably is saying every now and then, how long, Lord? Well, this pandemic will be gone. Even though we pray so much in this platform, Lord, hunungan na ning a pandemic, kuhain na niyong gahong. But yet, as if the Lord is not listening to that kind of prayer. He has His own time. And it's that time that we have is a time that we can put our trust in Him. You know, while there is no way to avoid sorrow, there is no way to avoid adversity, there is no way to avoid distress in life, there are ways to help us smooth the rough waters so that we can still move on. Why do some people seem to be better able to cope up, to overcome problems, challenges in life? While everyone's situation is different, it is true that people with resilience, as they said, people who have trusted the Lord, are able to tolerate, go with it, sing along, as Bob Cranston said, you can roll with the punches so that you will not be hit, and then move back again and fight back. It is our trust in the Lord. You know, allow me just to say to you, in these days that I had been going through grief, in which I empathize people have gone through grief, and I have a new appreciation of that now. Serving as a pastor, ministering to bereaved family for so many years, I never understood how difficult it is to go through grief, sorrows, and bereavement. 8 months had passed, Ruth passed away. After a few days that she has gone, a friend sent me an email about 10 stages of grief, written by Granger Westberg in the book called Good Grief. In that short letter email, he mentioned the 10 stages. And as I reflect on those stages, it is true that some people respond very well and quickly and move forward. But it is also true that there are people who are not able to learn quickly. And even for a long time, the grieving process is still going on. We all feel grief in our life, or we all face grief in our life. It may not be now, but it will come. I believe each individual, each one of us, respond differently to grief when it comes to us. The first stage that I have learned going through that kind of 10 stages is a shock. Characterized by numbness and saying, what is happening to me? The second stage is that emotional release. Sometimes you just do not know your feelings. You want to shout, even to people that are so close to you. something that many of us could not understand. The third stage is somewhat difficult, depression and isolation, the feeling of loneliness. The feeling that you are alone, even though you are in the midst of many people. There is just a moment that feeling of depression and isolation will come in. Then there is that physical illness, the excess of that stress that you have gone through, that our immune system will be weakened. Gamay-gamay lang na ulan, sipunong dayon. Why? Because our immune system has been weakened because of that stress that we have gone through. And then there is the stage of panic and anxiety. You feel abandoned. Even though you are with your family, even though you are with your group, friends can help. And I admire my friends. People are asking me, how are you doing? I say to them, I'm okay, but not in every way. That's good. It's an encouragement. Then there is that anger and hostility. You feel the pain. And you are just, could not understand your feelings. And then there is that guilt. And there is that stage of difficulty returning to your routine that you're doing. RJ asked me one time, Pa, wa na lagi ka mag-grass cutter karon. As my routine for so many years, grass cutting our yard. So I told her, no, what anak ko gana, RJ? The excitement at times is being curtailed. It's because of that. But there's one thing beautiful. It's hopefulness. You know, as Christians, we are hopeful that we will see our loved ones once again. And I believe that is an encouragement. But the last stage, as Granger had said in her book, in his book, acceptance and moving forward. I like that. Acceptance and moving forward. Gradually it comes. You know, in this pandemic time, I have seen that it's not easy for some other people and for many of us. We all go through bad times. We all experience disappointment. We all experience loss. We all experience changes. And we feel sad, anxious, stressed at many times in our lives. This pandemic has delivered wake-up call to all of us. And sometimes you are stretched too thin. And I believe it's time to build, trusting God all the more. And reading His Word and being with His people. Why? It is God's plan for us. If you want to make the rest of your life the best of your life, we need to allow the Lord Jesus Christ to be the Lord of our life. We need to put Him first in our lives. And we live every moment for Him, and He will take care of the rest. You know, it is not easy to think our problems are too small and insignificant to be any concern about our God. But you know, in reality, that our God, the creator of the universe, cares about you and me. So much so that He wants us to cast all our anxieties to Him. We all know 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7, casting all your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. Other translation, it says, cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you. Many children can memorize this, but I do not know. I have memorized this when I was a kid, but I did not know how deep it is. Now I realize the reality that God really cares for us. Amen. And that is a wonderful thing for a believer, that God is here, God is here, God is here. I will put my hope in the Lord, in His love and its firm foundation. And I will put my trust in Him, and I will not be shaken. I believe this is very important to us. Just after telling the Philippian believers that God's peace will guard their hearts and anxiety, the Apostle Paul said, this is the secret of being content in any situation that we are in. But we cannot do this with our own. To be content when times are hard, we have to depend on God's strength, not on our own. Thankfully, and praise God, God can give us strength when we come to Him in prayer. That's why in Philippians chapter 4, verse 12, he said, and 13, I know that what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have in plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And that's why David said in Psalms 121, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, He guards Israel, shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your guardian. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not harm you during the day, nor the moon during the night. The Lord shall protect you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. He shall preserve your going out and coming in from now on and forevermore. What a reality. There is never a moment in our lives that God doesn't know exactly what is going on in our lives, my friends. He's watching over you, waiting to help us. Whatever our need, no matter how insignificant, we can simply come and ask Him, Lord, help me. And so we can just tell our friends, I am now living in the best of my life. It is because God is on my side. Now, with all of these challenges, these problems, difficulties we are facing, how can we have hope? How can we have joy in the midst of the sufferings, when everything looks hopeless? In our sufferings, we can depend on God's presence. In our sufferings, we can depend that God will provide. As many of you have testified that even in this midst of pandemic, so much blessing that have come into our home, provisions, food, whatever it is, God has just provided. Why? Because even in the midst of suffering, God will provide. In our sufferings, we can depend on God's power. Even though God will not respond to us the way we want Him to respond and heal the bodies, because He has another and greater plans for us. You know, in this life that we're facing today, we hear so many voices. Voices like that of, quit, give up, let it go, for this is just life. As the song says, que sera, sera, what will be, but not for us. God is here. We put our trust in Him, and therefore we cannot be shaken. Friends, whether you are struggling with the fear and isolation of this novel coronavirus COVID-19, there are just a day in our lives that nothing seems to go right, but we must rely in our faith in the Lord. Struggling in this life, I believe, is normal. But it is up to you and me to believe in God and put our trust in Him alone. Let us remember that God is bigger than COVID-19. He is bigger than any bad day that we have. And our time on earth is but just temporary. But God has given us the gift of heaven, which is more, have a higher value. So you may ask, what is faith in times like these? In times of so much problems, in times of so much troubles, in times even in death and many things. You know, friends, faith in times of sickness, it means believing God all the more. Do not doubt. Put your faith in the Lord. In sickness, trust the Lord. Believe in God all the more. What is faith in times of trials? It means standing firm in the promises of God. What is faith in times of great need? All of us have needs. It is trusting that the Lord will supply. What is faith in times of suffering? It is perseverance that we can experience victory, overcome whatever it is that we're facing today. In these very strange days, today or ahead of us, on this pandemic, coronavirus, let us believe that God is still at work, accomplishing His eternal plans. May He give us His wisdom to trust Him all the more and walk in His ways. For truly, in every generation, this is His unchanging promise, that He is our dwelling place in this life and in the one to come. As I've shared on the first night on the funeral service of Hazel Samson Bergara, I said to the people, we have been preparing ourselves for this life, but what about the next life, which is more than this life? That's why Paul said in Philippians chapter 4, verse 8, finally, brothers, whatever things are true, whatever things are honest, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are good report, if there is any virtue, if there is any praise, think on these things. We are born again to fulfill God's plan for our lives. Whether you like it or not, when you're born again, we are to fulfill God's plan for our lives. And that purpose is to conform to the image of the Son of God. We are born again to fulfill God's plan for our lives, and that plan God prepared beforehand that we should walk in it. So the road is already built. Ang agianan gihimo na. Let us continue to walk in it. The question is, are you walking on that road, on that plan that God has given to you and for me? Looking around us, do not lose heart. But instead, let us continue to do what Moses did and said in Psalms 90, verse 1. He said, "Let us seek the Lord as our dwelling place and walk in wisdom that an eternal perspective gives us." May God bless us today. Amen.
Thank you, Bishop Jim, for that wonderful message today. Indeed, when we have Jesus in our lives and we hid His words in our hearts, we walk and we live sa iyong mga commandments, then we are stable enough that we build our lives in Him. So let us all stand and let us sing a second song this morning, build my life.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We'll live for you.
Show me who you are. Closing prayer. Can you look around? Can you pray for that person next to you before we leave in this church? Pwede ba natong pag-pray, whisper a prayer para sa ila as I also pray? Let's close our eyes and let's come to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we thank you for the encouragement from your word through your servant. We thank you for the messages of the song, that you are our firm foundation. And we will go out from this church, Lord, with that foundation in mind and heart. You are our foundation. In this world, there are a lot of challenges, physical challenges, emotional, mental, spiritual, even material challenges. But we thank you, Lord, that in you there is always the assurance. In you, Lord, there is always the answer. Our health is dependent upon you. And we just thank you, Lord, because everything that would happen in this life, mahitabo, Lord, pero naa ang imong gugma, naa ang imong grasya na guban ka namo. As we go out from this place, we pray, Father, that your Holy Spirit will be upon us, guide us, journey with us, bless our families, bless all the tatay na naakaron Ginoo, all the mothers, and even their coming activities. Bless them, Lord. Encourage them. Bless all our YA, our young people, our students. Even as the school year is about to end, we pray that you will bless all students and children in our church. Lord, may your divine mercy and grace be upon us. May your comfort be upon those, our brothers and sisters, who are grieving over the loss of their loved ones. Salamat sa imong pag-uban, Ginoo. Thank you for your word. Thank you for the blessing that we receive from you today. We also give you praise, glory, and honor in your name alone, in Jesus' name. Now let's receive the benediction. And may the God of peace himself will sanctify you through and through. May your spirit, your soul, and your body be kept blameless until the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ in glory. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will surely do it. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning. Have a great day ahead.